Does your law firm need to report its financial information periodically? Well, then you need to watch this video, Adjusting Balances for Reporting. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Right now, unearned income in our records is not correct. The unearned account is supposed to match the total of all clients' balances. After the last video regarding post-service paying clients, the balance of unearned does not reflect the actual amount of unearned legal fees. The balance of the later paying clients do not belong in the unearned income account. They belong in a different account that reflects what is actually owed back to us. Unearned income is understated right now by the amount of the balances of the late paying clients. All late paying clients' balances should be in another account in the chart of accounts called legal fees receivable. So when is it important to fix this? Well, you can operate on a day-to-day basis with a single inaccurate trial balance account, and that's fine. You can always check the account in the customer balance summary report to see how much of the unearned balance is for prepaid clients and how much is for clients who pay after receiving the legal services. So, from the left panel, we click Reports, and do not go to Custom this time. Go to Standard and scroll down to the section of Who Owes You and click Customer Balance Summary. Now notice there are negative numbers for clients whom we owe future services to, and there's a positive balance that represents that they owe us money for future services. And let's go ahead and click Save Customization and then click Save. And well, I already did this, but if you didn't do it, just save it so that you can click Reports, Custom Reports, and now the Customer Balance Summary is in the section of the special reports that we use for a law firm. Now, if you need to create accurate financial statements, you can make a normal accountant adjustment along with other normal accountant adjustments to make the numbers more accurate for reporting purposes. So what exactly needs adjusting? Well, unearned legal fees has something that it should not. We need to pull out from unearned legal fees the balances of the later paying clients and put them into another account that represents the legal fees that we are owed from the client. The money that we are owed from the client for past legal services. And in order to do that, we make a general journal entry. So here's the customer balance summary the way it looks. The two negative numbers are the true reflection of the unearned income. So the unearned legal fees should really be listed as a total of $7,000 in the trial balance. And this $2,000 balance that Candy has really belongs in another report or another account called Legal Fees Receivable. So let's go ahead and put legal fees receivable in the chart of accounts. We click the cog wheel. We go over to chart of accounts in the left column. Now we click New. Now, the type should be accounts receivable, and I will explain this in a moment, but the name should be legal fees receivable. And then we click Save and Close. So before we make the adjustment, let's remember the amounts. The two negative numbers actually belong in unearned legal fees, and this positive number is what we're pulling out of the unearned account and bringing to the new account, legal fees receivable. Let's go ahead and make the journal entry. From the top left, we click New. Then we go all the way to the right and we click Journal Entry. Now, the date of the journal entry should be the date that we're reporting the numbers. And in this example, it's January 31 of 2021. Click under the word account to bring the pull-down arrow. Then click on the arrow to choose the first receivable account that we put on the list originally, unearned legal fees. Because that was the first accounts receivable type account, that's the one that will match the customer's balances. So, on the same line as unearned legal fees, we have to put the customer whose balance we're pulling out. And the amount we're pulling out is $2,000. Click in the credit column on the same row and push tab. Keep pushing tab. Okay, now, the account that we just created, which was legal fees receivable, that gets debit for $2,000. Because if you studied accounting, you know that this is an asset that we are increasing so we can report the proper numbers. So this becomes debit, the other one becomes credit. And if you never studied accounting, don't worry. It doesn't matter. Just follow the steps and apply them to your situation. And of course, the customer's balance always comes with it. So this is how we adjust customer by customer, client by client, when we are ready to report our numbers to make them correct. Now we click Save and Close at the bottom, and you will see when we click Reports, Trial Balance, you will see that the numbers are now correct. Unearned legal fees is now the correct number to be placed on the balance sheet. And legal fees receivable is also the correct number that can be placed on the balance sheet in the asset section. This can be placed on the balance sheet in the liability section. This would go on the profit and loss, and this would go, of course, on the balance sheet. And the accountant would have accurate numbers to make the financial reports. That's the good news. Now, the bad news is that we now must delete or reverse this adjustment. So after the numbers are reported, the adjustment must be reversed. This is because the invoices from late paying clients will be paid after reporting the numbers. In QuickBooks Online, recording receiving invoice payments will change the unearned account. That's a behavior that we cannot change in QuickBooks Online, but it will make our numbers wrong again. So we must reverse it. We must reverse this journal entry until we need to formally report our financial statements again. And then when we need to report it again, we will do the same type of adjustment, go and report the numbers, then come back to QuickBooks Online and delete it. We only need to report once a year, or at maximum if you have a large firm, once a quarter, and it's only a 1 second adjustment for each individual client's balance if you need to. And of course, there are other summary solutions if you have a full-time accountant working with you, and that accountant might think of other ways to adjust before reporting. But for our purposes, let's go and delete that entry. Let's double-click Legal Fees Receivable, and you see the journal entry is right here, journal entry, double-click. At the moment the transaction or adjustment is in front of you, the one that you want to delete, you go to the bottom and click More and click Delete. Are you sure? Yes. Now, when we go back to the trial balance, the numbers are the way they were before. But we need them to be this way when we operate on a day-to-day basis, and we only stop and adjust when we need to report, then remove the adjustment and continue forward.